So the Australian National Emergency Group is meeting as we go to air tonight following a catastrophic system failure that's hit Microsoft computers around the world. Here in Australia, it shut down banks, hospitals, shipping ports and media outlets. Some airlines have been forced to ground planes, with airports also affected. The outage occurred around 3 p.m, as Waleed said. It's believed a botched software update is behind the global chaos. Computers crashed, showing users what's now been dubbed the blue screen of death. If you've seen it, you know what I'm talking about. The National Cybersecurity Co-Coordinator, Michelle McGuinness, says that it relates to a technical issue and not a cyber attack. Microsoft says it's investigating an issue with its 365 apps and services.
You may have noticed that Georgia just read a whole headline with no vision at all.
Right.
That's going to happen a lot tonight. Cybersecurity expert Ben Aylett is the host of the podcast West Coast Cyber and joins us now. Ben, what happened?
Hi, guys. What happened?
Yes.
Well, happy Friday, right?
Yes.
It looks like we've had a software update pushed out. And this is from the guys at CrowdStrike do a great job. Sometimes we trip up and, sometimes it's a big trip up. So it looks like this software has actually caused some problems for Windows workstations from what I'm getting so far. It's a quickly developing story. But it looks like we've had a software update that's caused Windows systems to break down and, worldwide chaos.
So this is like when you update something on your iPhone and then you can't get your contacts anymore, except this updated and shut down the world. That's what we're looking at.
To put it crudely, yes.
Okay, great. So glad we clarified.
Yeah, good. Because, Ben, what on earth is happening? How on earth could this be possible?
Well, that's a good one. I think it's because, CrowdStrike being a good system, it's a good cybersecurity system, it's used throughout a lot of enterprise and corporate level accounts and customers. And, of course, everyday people like us, we depend on these systems to be available. And so when one thing goes down, it's sort of like a house of cards.
Oh, my gosh.
But this has grounded flights and stopped public transport. Shipping ports are down. Banks are down. How is it possible that as a society we're just so reliant on this one system?
How is it possible? It's just something that's convenient. It's something that's evolved over time and, it's something that's made life better until it doesn't.
Yeah. It's not bloody convenient now.
And we all know CrowdStrike now.
It's true. Someone lost a job today, by the way. Yeah. How much worse could this get, Ben?
At the moment, it looks like that all we're suffering right now is just some systems not being available. So we're not looking at any permanent damage, so I don't think we'll be seeing any loss of data, so to speak. So it looks like just availability of systems. But it could get worse. We could see things like troves of data just disappear.
Oh, excellent. Sorry, I thought it was just a convenience issue at this point. But so what do they do?
Yes.
Do they send up another update that then fixes the bad update, in which case how do any of the computers update when the computer that would download the update is not working to get the up? Do you understand what I mean about the update?
We trust the update.
Yeah. I understand. And look, this is where we need to be really kind to our IT support people, because this is not a problem they caused, but it's one they've got to fix. So just be kind to your IT guys and girls.
I mean, that's not a solution, but sure. All right. Hassan on IT, it's on you. Ben, thank you very much for your time.
Anytime, guys.
I'm not coping.
And also that it's happening on a Friday afternoon when everyone's probably left.
Yeah.
You'd have to get the IT people back. Maybe they'll be, has gone down to the pub as well. You know what I mean? Who knows how this is going
to
solve?
It really did appear to be the end of times when this was happening this afternoon. Yeah. I mean, it was like the weirdest domino effect where it was like, I've still got a computer, blue screen. I've still got a computer, blue screen, blue screen, blue screen, blue screen.
I know, it felt like that dystopian future that we've read about and that it's coming, and all of a sudden it was like, oh, this is it. I've only got two cans of spaghetti in the cupboard. I'm out.
Yeah, it was genuinely extraordinary.